Hey guys, Rory Reid here from Recombu, and today I'm checking out the brand new Panasonic Lumix CM1, one of the sexiest phones on the market today. It's so sexy, in fact, it makes me want to just put on my Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles costume and... Wait, what? Anyway, not only is it sexy, it's very, very unique. First of all, it's hugely expensive, between £700 and £1,000. Secondly, you have to fill in a questionnaire with Panasonic before you can buy one to see if you're suitable. And thirdly, it's not even a smartphone, it's a communication camera. You see, whereas most phones are smartphones with built-in cameras, this is a camera with a built-in Android phone. All it takes is one look at the thing and you'll see exactly what I mean. It looks more like a compact camera, and a damn sexy one at that. It's also very thick. Here it is next to an iPhone 6 Plus. It's massive, and it's also reasonably heavy. It's definitely not a phone you can get into your pocket that easily. Not one for the skinny jeans crew. The fact it's so big is actually a really good thing. It means you can get a really secure grip. Most of us tend to hold our camera phones like that because you tend to obscure the camera and accidentally touch the screen. But with the CM1, you can hold it with one hand, and even though your finger is resting on the screen, you don't accidentally press any buttons. You can really run and gun with this, and your finger falls right on the shutter button. Feels just like a camera. The fact it's finished in this fake leather helps too. It's really grippy, although it might not be to everyone's tastes. I definitely don't like the matching leather wallpaper, but that's just me. More on the lens in a minute. Let's take a look around that sexy, sexy body. Here you've got your power button, and to the left of that, a volume rocker. To the right of the power button is a slider switch that you can use for rapid access to the camera. A lot of phones have this feature, but this one's really quick to use. The fact it's different from the other buttons means you always remember which one you're supposed to press, and it feels really satisfying as well. On the bottom of the phone, you've got a flap that reveals a micro SD card slot and a SIM card slot. It's actually quite good because you don't have to peel off the entire back of the phone to install your SIM card. On the flip side, you can't remove the back of the phone, so there's no removable battery, so you can't carry a spare. Finally, on the left-hand side, you've got a 3.5mm headphone jack and a flap for the micro USB port. On the whole, I think the design is absolutely fantastic. You're gonna stand out when you use this thing, especially when you've got this massive lens on the front, although you might look a bit like an idiot. Incidentally, that lens isn't just for show. It hasn't got optical zoom, unfortunately, but it does have a really cool rotating ring that lets you adjust settings depending on what mode you're in. You can zoom in with it, you can change the ISO, the shutter speed, etc., etc. Behind all that is a 20 megapixel sensor. If that doesn't sound that impressive, then get this. The sensor size is 1 inch, and that's about 7 times larger than the sensors you get on ordinary smartphone cameras. That means it can soak up a hell of a lot more information about the scene that you're trying to capture. We'll come to image quality in a minute, but one of the really cool things about the CM1 is the amount of control it gives you when you're taking pictures. If you tap the icon at the top left side, you can access the PASM control wheel. If you're into your cameras, you'll know what this is, but in case you're not, this is a selector wheel that lets you change the shooting modes. You've got program, aperture priority, shutter priority, manual, panorama, and a couple of customizable modes, and a few others. On a DSLR, these functions can be quite intimidating, and that's kind of the case here, but Panasonic also provide a couple of auto modes. Just whack it into auto or auto plus, and it'll usually do a great job of taking the perfect picture for you. But if you want to unleash your creative side, there are also some creative presets, which are kind of like Instagram filters built into the phone. Some of them look great and can turn a boring photo into a work of art, but a couple really do slow the camera down. You can notice it chugging along as it tries to give you a preview of the effect, which can be quite annoying. So you probably want to know whether the Panasonic CM1 is any good. The answer is yes, very. The first thing you'll notice is the amazingly shallow depth of field. It's got a fixed focal length of 28mm and will capture between f2.8 and f11 equivalent aperture. And this helps you get some pretty solid bokeh or background defocus. You can keep your subject really sharp but have the background super blurry to give it the kind of feel you get from a DSLR. or you can keep the entire scene perfectly crisp if you want. In terms of general image quality, it's really impressive. Color reproduction is accurate, white balance is great, and there's plenty of detail in your shots. And it remains impressive in a variety of situations. If you're in a room with good, even lighting, then portrait shots look great, the selfie cam's a bit average. Macros are fantastic. It's even impressive in low light. The ISO goes from 100 to 25,600. Outside, panoramas are great too, and because you can mess about with the settings so much, you can get shots with this thing that would be absolutely impossible on a normal camera phone. This thing even shoots in the raw image format, and that means you can manipulate your images to within an inch of their lives. Even if you shoot a picture and it doesn't look all that fantastic to begin with, you can recover so much lost detail and turn it into a work of art. In fact, that's what I found myself doing the most with this phone. You take a picture and it sometimes doesn't look that fantastic to begin with, but rest assured, you whack it into Photoshop and you can end up with a really fantastic picture. As for video, well, it even shoots 4K, although only at 15 frames per second, and that might not be that usable for some people. It's not perfect. First of all, it doesn't have optical image stabilization, and that means some of your pictures can come out a little bit blurry if you've got the wrong settings on or you're in the wrong mode. It doesn't have a quarter inch tripod screw in there, so you can't mount it on a tripod very easily, and the battery life is pretty shocking. If you're shooting constantly with this thing, stills or video, you might end up with as little as half a day's worth of battery life. And again, no removable battery. Ultimately, the CM1 is not on a par with a digital SLR, nor is it quite as good as a Micro Four Thirds, but it's right up there with a decent compact and streets ahead of every camera phone I've ever tested. Would I buy one? Well, I'm not sure, maybe. If you're the kind of person that doesn't want to carry around a dedicated camera like a DSLR and a phone, then I'd recommend it, but you're gonna have to be prepared to spend big. I think that's pretty much it. Oh yeah, it makes calls. It's not bad at that, actually. So that's the Panasonic Lumix CM1. I think it's pretty good. Let me know what you think in the comments below, or if you have any questions, then leave them down there for me and I'll do my best to answer you. Also, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share the video. See you guys soon.